Hello students, welcome to the video of 7th General Science. We have already started chapter number 12, the muscular system and digestive system in human being. You can check the first part at the right corner of the screen. Now today we are going to discuss about the digestive system. There are so many organ systems present in our body, and digestive system is one of the important organ system in our body. So we know that food is very essential to perform the work by the humans, and this energy we get from the food. And when we eat this food, this complex food is converted into the soluble form, and then it is absorbed into the blood, and that process we call the digestion. Now the digestion system is consist of alimentary canal and digestive glands. These are the two important parts of the digestive system. Now alimentary canal is consist of mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. So these are the all parts which combine to make the alimentary canal of the digestive system. And the total length of the alimentary canal is 9 meter. From mouth to the anus, the length is 9 meter. Now let's see in the figure. You can see the oral cavity means mouth, then pharynx, then esophagus, then stomach, then large intestine, small intestine, rectum and anus. These all parts combine to form the alimentary canal of the digestive system. And digestive glands consist of salivary glands, which are present in mouth. Then liver, pancreas are the glands which are attached to the alimentary canal to secrete their enzymes in the food. Now let's see about the other organs in our digestive system. Now teeth is also the important part of our digestive system. The process of digestion starts in our mouth by chewing by the teeth. When we put the food in the mouth, we chew it with the help of teeth. There are some types of teeth in our mouth. There are four types of teeth. First is the canine, then molars, incisors and premolar are the four types of teeth. Now each type of teeth has different functions, like tearing, chewing, biting, breaking. These are the functions of this teeth. There are 32 teeth in our mouth, and when we start to chew, the process of digestion begins. Now when we start the chewing of the food, during that the saliva from the salivary glands, which contains the ptyalin, mix with the food, and the function of this enzyme is to convert the starch into the sugar, and that sugar is called the maltose. Means the process of digestion actually starts into mouth, during when the starch is converted into the maltose. Now next organ is the mouth. As I told you, the process of digestion of the food starts with the begin. Mouth contains teeth, and these teeth convert the food into the fine pieces. Next is the pharynx. The esophagus and the trachea open into the pharynx. Next is the salivary glands. So these glands produce saliva, and this saliva is added to the food during the chewing of the food by the teeth. These salivary glands are located into the mouth cavity near the ears and below our tongue. This saliva bring to the mouth via duct and mix with the food. Next is the esophagus. It is a tube-like structure. It starts from the pharynx and goes up to the stomach, and it provides the food from the mouth to the stomach. Then you can see in the pictures, the brown tube is the esophagus, which take food from the pharynx to the stomach. Next is the pancreas. Pancreas secrete the pancreatic juice that contains various enzymes, and this pancreatic juice is also important to control the blood sugar. The next organ is the stomach. Stomach is a sac-like structure, and it is the part of the alimentary canal. When the food enters in the stomach, it churns into the fine mixture. Stomach has three compartments of the gastric juice, and these gastric juice are hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. When the food is turning into the fine mixture, these gastric juices mix up with the food and food become acidic, and due to that the microorganism in the food get destroyed. The digestion of proteins is mainly takes place in the stomach, and after that the small amount of food is pushed into the small intestine through the stomach for the further digestion. Next organ is large intestine. The length of the large intestine is 1.5 meter long, and the absorption of water is only takes place in the large intestine. The appendix, the part appendix is attached to the first part of the large intestine. The undigested remains of the food in the small intestine is coming to the large intestine, and then it is thrown out of the body through the anus. Next is the small intestine. Though the name is small intestine, it is larger than the large intestine. It has the length of 6 meter, and most of the digestion and absorption of food into the blood takes place in the small intestine. Liver is the largest gland of the body, and it has a rich supply of blood, and the main function of the liver is to store the glucose from the food. So these are the organs in our digestive system which perform their work to carry out the process of digestion very smoothly.